scenic. And you get to see a lot more. But for sure, I mean, you know, Denali and up there in the interior is a very, very pretty place.
That way you see the sun more all day and night?
No, you'll see more sun here in Southeast Alaska usually. We do get a lot of rain here, and so the clouds, I guess if you factor in the clouds blocking out the sun, I mean, that could probably account for more sunshine up in the interior. But they are farther north, so during the winter time, you know, they get less sunshine than we do usually.
Okay.
Because they're farther north than we are.
Another sort of basic and the same and then on that same
I mean longer hours of
day or night. Almost winter they have a small daylight.
Yeah, in the winter we, you know, sometimes we'll only get 4 to 6 hours of daylight, so we have some pretty short days here. Alright, coming up around this bend is one of my favorite views in all of Juneau. I love getting to see the cruise ships in like this. I just think it's amazing. You know, we've got 4 cruise ships in today, and like I said, I just love seeing the cruise ships with the Alaskan landscape in the background. I think it's one of the most beautiful sights that we have here. I really like it.
Souvenir, it says.
Oh, the penny, you did the penny thing?
Yeah, it says, follow my ass to the Red Dog Saloon, Juneau, Alaska. Pretty flower. It's like part daisy, part pansies.
The cloud came on the mountain.
Yeah.
The shadow.
Of our helicopter's shadow on the mountain, so you can see how far away we were.
Pesky buses, out of our way. We'll probably pull up really quick and just wait. But anyways, in the meantime, welcome to Juneau, everybody. My name is Kyle. Nice to meet you.
Hello, guys.
Hi, everybody.
Hi.
I have no clue what your names are, but oh well. You can tell me when you get off the bus. That'd be fun. So I will be taking you to Allen Marine. Allen Marine's about 25 to 30 minutes away. So I'll be taking you first to Allen Marine, where you'll get on a whale watching boat and go out whale watching, have a party, see lots of whales, take lots of pictures. Then a couple hours later, I will be back to pick you guys up and bring you back to the dock. So that is our plan for today.
Now we have people from all over the world on this bus, but believe it or not, the reason why we are all here today is because of that creek. That's the reason.
In the year 1880, two men by the names of Joe Juneau and Richard Harris were led by an
by a Tlingit Indian chief, Chief Cowie, to that little creek. They went about a mile upstream from the spot you just saw. They reached into the water and pulled out gold nuggets the size of beans. Big old chunks of gold, which got them extremely excited. So they established a mining camp, which eventually grew and grew to the town that you see today of 32,000 people. It's about 32,000, 33,000 in Alaska. It's not raining, which is awesome. Considering it rains almost all the time here in Juneau, we do live right next to the Tongass National Forest, which is the biggest temperate rainforest in the world. It's huge. It extends all the way up to Canada. And of course, when you live next to a rainforest, you get quite a lot of the wet stuff. Rain. All the time. On average, Juneau, Alaska has about 40 days out of the entire year where it is not raining or snowing. See? Disneyland, Alaska. You don't want to miss it. It's the newest, hottest resort. Now this lake here is called the Twin Lakes. We've got this lake, and as we come around this corner, you'll see another lake almost identical to this one. Now you folks can see those houses on the lakefront. Now the ocean is over here on our left, of course. The ocean used to go all the way up to those people's front doors. They used to have oceanfront property. However, Juneau decided that we needed a four-lane highway. We didn't have one. We didn't have one in Southeast Alaska even. So we built this highway. You can drive. And all of a sudden, those folks who had oceanfront property had a big, dirty brown spot and a highway in front of their house. So of course, they were kind of mad. Understandably so. So once again, Juneau got together in a massive construction project and built these two lakes. So Twin Lakes are man-made lakes. So those folks that used to have oceanfront property now have lakefront property. And of course, the city of Juneau can tax them more for having waterfront property. So everybody's happy, everybody wins. Juneau, take a look to your right. It's our local Walmart. Now look way on the mountain behind that Walmart. There's a glacier, you guys see it?
Yep.
That is called the Hanging Glacier. Isn't that beautiful? It's called the Hanging Glacier, making that the only Walmart in the world with a glacier in the background. Pretty sweet, eh?
And the helicopter flying.
Kind of our claim to fame. Funny thing about that Walmart, it used to be a Target. Before it was a Target, it was a Kmart. Keeps changing on us. Who knows what it'll be next? We do have a Walmart. You will see that picture that you just saw on more Alaskan calendar. This 36,000 pound vehicle down this ramp with about 50 people onto that floating dock. This is what we call the biggest roller coaster in Juneau. So, heck, you're on vacation. Let's treat it like a roller coaster. Can everyone throw your arms in the air and scream? Woohoo! Break this. Now which direction are we turning?
Left.
That's right.
You're turning left, that's right?
Alright, well thank you so much guys. If you'll hold tight for just a moment, I'll grab the step stool and let you guys off. Once you get off, you'll go down a ramp onto this boat. The ramp will be on your left, so once you get off the bus, just go in front of the bus and go to the left. And have a magnificent time, guys.
Life vests for all of you with the under seats, and then the token of life vests will be painted on the back of the boat on the first. Okay.
Oh, there they are.
There are a lot of them together there.
Yeah.
Oh, there's one close.
Dad, look.
Woo, that's so close.
Here they come. Here they come. Did you get those?
Yeah, I think so.
Alright. Yeah, this little baby right here.
Yeah, there's one right here.
Here goes baby. Oh, and a no food. Oh, you know what?
Should we kind of hang out in this area for a while? I know you should, bro.
Yeah, and there's actually a second group down there. There are a ton of whales here. Baby's still up. Maybe baby will get active.
There's a funny museum down in Ketchikan. You guys are heading there next to the Ray Troll Museum. He's an artist. And one of his shirts, his art down there, is a salmon in it with hearts around it. So the fish that dies for love. Because after they release their eggs or their milk, they die. One life cycle, that's it. And so after they return to that exact same home stream, they wouldn't find it though if they changed any composition. So if we were taking out the forest in a place where there's a bunch of salmon streams, we cut down a bunch of trees, the salmon wouldn't return. So we have to make sure that we aren't affecting the fresh water as well as the salt water, or we would limit our fish around Alaska.
Oh, there's another one.
Oh yeah, there's two. Mom, there's two. There's one.
There were two.
You guys are only the fifth group I've had this entire season that I've seen orcas. Right, everything's cool, but then the dog up and dies in Anchorage. But she wanted to bury it in Juneau. So without telling anybody, she takes the dog's dead body and puts it into a cargo crate and loads it in. She gets here to Juneau, the dog's alive. Yeah, so she just looks at it and she says, something's wrong here, that's not my dog. And they said, what are you talking about? Of course it's your dog. She said, no, my dog was dead. And then they confess. They discover that the dog was dead during the flight, so they called in and had them bring a very similar dog in. Yeah, and then they tried to cover it up. So, can I smell a lawsuit? Yes, I can. Imagine that. I've also got a buddy here who's a cop. He was telling me we do have a maximum security prison here. It's usually not violent crimes that the people are doing first. They immediately crack down on that. Our biggest issue is public drunkenness. And the police know every drunk by their first name. They're on a first name basis here. They're nipping at the salmon as they're swimming up the creek, which is really rude in my opinion, but just look and you'll see the salmon. Yeah, it's getting dark. Also, coming up here on the right, ring finger, you wear a ring of silver, so that's the silver salmon. And then finally, your pinky represents the pink salmon. Pretty nice, huh?
Yeah.
And one thing you might notice as you're driving around here is a lot of drivers like to give each other the pink salmon finger salute. And if that wasn't bad enough, that building is also built upon the only earthquake fault line in Juneau. And it's our local high school. But if any of you are lucky enough to get caught in an avalanche, how would you figure out which direction you need to dig in order to escape? Anybody know?
Yeah.
You gotta spit. If you spit, then the spit will fall in the direction of gravity, and then you dig in the opposite direction, and you'll get out. And you see how it just spit? And then they all turn to each other and he whispers the answer and all together they go, oh. Almost as if they wish they had known that.
This was a
And they're all, that would be a pretty cool picture, getting a picture of them on that little pier right there. And, anywho, off to the left, about halfway up the hill, you guys are gonna see a white mansion with three chimneys coming out of the top. See the pillars right there? Yeah, it kind of looks like the Haunted Mansion right from Disneyland. See, that is the Governor's Mansion, former house of Sarah Palin, current home of Governor Sean Parnell. Great thing about it is that they both have the exact same initials, so they didn't have to change the embroidering on the silk pajamas. And so we also have the tram. Anybody?
All right.
Okay? Okay, for the lobster and for the fish.
It's always
chefs as we can, but if you're still eating, they're still cooking, they're still washing dishes, so they are behind the scenes, but I think if you can make enough noise, they will be able to hear your appreciation. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, let's hear it for the chefs! I think they heard you. Now also, we need to settle a little bet between our food and beverage manager and our restaurant manager. So if you think that you've had the best waiter, assistant waiter, sommelier, please let me hear you cheer. Yeah. Louder. Well, I'm not very good at making decisions, but we do have our hotel director, Jamie, over there. Jamie, what do you think? Invite you to join myself and the officers at 10:30 in the Crystal Room for the hilarious show Dancing with the Stripes. Have a great night. Good night.
it around, you drag out over here around.
No, no, it's a banana. 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 They are doing something. That's one of their boats. That boat has to come up.
Only the guide
them? No, no. Oh, you know what? They are observing to make sure that these guys did the
doing
job
the right
what they are supposed to do. If you have to go to the ship, you will have to go to the ship. Otherwise, the whole rope will break.
Yeah.
So once they make sure that the ropes have been cleared, then they will put the boat back up.
They
are all going. Now I know what they are here for. Inspector again. Oh, front to karaya hoega? Is it coming to the back? Or maybe the other way around, one of the ajarin and the crew. That's what I was telling you, you know, we need to see that. They're being rolled back into the ship. ਕਿਉਂਕਿ ਜੇ ਅਗਰ ਨਾ ਉਹ ਉੱਥੋਂ ਇੰਡੀਕੇਸ਼ਨ ਹੋਏ ਕਿ ਚੱਲ ਪਓ ਅਤੇ ਐਪ ਆਏ ਹੋਣ ਤਾਂ ਆਹ ਪੱਟ ਦੇਗਾ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਸਾਰੇ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਦੇ ਬਿੰਗ ਇਕੱਠੇ ਹੋ ਰਹੇ ਸੀ ਦੇ ਹੈਵ ਦੀਸ ਪ੍ਰੋਸੀਜਰਸ ਡਿਵੈਲਪ ਓਵਰ ਲੌਂਗ ਪੀਰੀਅਡ ਆਫ ਟਾਈਮ ਓਬਜ਼ਰਵ ਕਰ ਰਹੇ ਨੇ ਉਹਦੇ ਪਾਣੀ 'ਚ ਫਿਸ਼ ਜੰਪ ਕਰੀ ਹੈ ਲਾਸਟ ਰੋਪ ਇਟ ਬੀਂਗ ਸੈਟ ਆ ਸ਼ੁਰੂ ਹੋ ਗਿਆ ਇੰਜਨ ਸ਼ੁਰੂਆਤ ਕਰਤੇ ਹੈ ਸੀ ਦੇ ਸਟਾਰਟਡ ਦ ਮੇਨ ਇੰਜਨ ਸੀ ਦਿਸ ਵਾਟਰ ਦੇ ਹੈਵ ਸਟਾਰਟਡ ਦ ਮੇਨ ਇੰਜਨ
This
is the last one actually to go. They are ready to leave. They probably took all of them away long time. ਨਹੀਂ ਦੇ ਆਰ ਔਨ ਦਾ ਪੋਰਟ ਤੇ
ਉੱਤੇ ਖੜੇ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਨੇ ਜਦੋਂ ਆਉਂਦੇ ਨੇ
ਮੈਂ ਲੋਟ ਆਫ ਪੀਪਲ ਵਾਚਿੰਗ ਦੈਟ
ਨਾ ਮੌਸਮ ਹੈ ਅੱਜ ਹੈ
ਚੜਾ ਦੇਣੀ ਇਹਨੇ ਹੁਣ ਬੰਨ ਕੇ ਨਾ ਉਹ ਹਾਂ ਹੁੱਕ ਸਿੰਨਾ ਟੰਗ ਦੇਣੀ ਉਹ Okay, we are leaving Ketchikan now. Full speed.
Yeah.
Population, other side is totally clear.
Is it? ਨਹੀਂ ਨਹੀਂ ਉਹ ਤਾਂ ਆਲਵੇਜ਼ ਕਿਉਂਕਿ ਉਹ ਤਾਂ ਕੁਛ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੈ ਕੋਈ ਖਾਸ ਉਹ ਤਾਂ ਇੱਕ ਦੋ ਚੀਜ਼ਾਂ ਨੇ ਮੇਨ ਲਾਈਨ ਤੇ ਕਹਾ ਹੈ ਨਾ Bye, Ketchikan. See you if I can. Different kind of scene that you won't be able to catch anywhere.
Yeah, this looks like one of those Mediterranean countries, Greece or something.
Uh-huh. I think that's the end of it, pretty much.
Yeah.
ਉੱਪਰ ਘਰ ਨਜ਼ਰ ਆਏ ਉਹ ਕਿੰਨੀ ਕੈਨ ਯੂ ਬਲੀਵ ਵੀ ਰਾਈਡ ਓਵਰ ਦੇਅਰ ਅਦਰ ਇਹ ਕੰਮ ਕਰਨੇ ਨਹੀਂ ਪੀਅਰ ਬਣੇ ਉਹ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਪੀਅਰ ਸੀ ਨਾ ਵੱਡੇ ਦੇ ਵਾ ਫੋਰ ਦ ਬਿਗ ਸ਼ਿਪ ਈਜ਼ ਫੋਰ ਸਮਾਲਰ ਬੋਟਸ ਐਂਡ ਅਦਰ ਸਮਾਲਰ ਸ਼ਿਪਸ ਐਂਡ ਅਦਰ ਸਟਫ
Mm-hmm.